Hey you, welcome back to my channel. Sorry guys for being kind of inactive. School just started, so I've been pretty busy. I also have a cold right now, so I apologize if my voice sounds nasally. If you're watching this video, I'm assuming you already know or have used pt.2 SAI for quite a while now, or you're fairly familiar to it, because as the title suggests, this will be an advanced guide, although I will be only covering four of the most useful techniques that I know to keep it short. So if you don't know what SAI is, never used SAI before, or just started using SAI, save this guide in your favorites and check out my pt.2 SAI, the ultimate guide for beginners video first. I'll make a pop-up on the bottom right about now, and I'll also link it in the description as well. But anyways, I highly recommend you watch the tutorial first. If you get confused, then you're probably not ready for this guide yet, but whatever, you can watch it anyways. You haven't been warned. Okay, so I'm gonna jump right into it now. First off, I'll start with the advanced functions on the color panel. Now this first trick was pretty much mind-blowing to me and changed how I use SAI forever. Because for those of you who have used Photoshop before, you should know that one of its perks is that not only can you choose and customize the brush to draw with, you can also choose and customize the brush to erase with. At first, it seems like SAI only has one default eraser, but in actuality, it does have a function equivalent to that. To activate it, all you have to do is check this checkered box here on the bottom left of your two main color palettes called Exchange Normal / Transparent Color. Now, this name makes absolutely no sense, but let me show you the magic. So when it is checked, basically all of your brushes become erasers. So this is super, super useful, especially for when you don't want to have such a hard edgy line that a default eraser gives you. And I especially like to use this function with the airbrush the most, since it erases things in a really nice gradient. Okay, now trick number two is up here on the layers panel. These two boxes up here, textures and effect, can be super, super helpful sometimes for finishing touches. I for one don't use textures as much, but it can create things like a cool canvas effect, like so. And yeah, you can also download different textures, but I haven't experimented with that as much, so maybe you can search up another tutorial on that. But anyways, for me, fringes are what helps the most. If you've ever watched my video on how to cel shade hair, you know exactly what I'm talking about. I usually apply it to my multiply layers when I'm shading. So here, let me pull up an example so you guys know what I mean. Okay, so yeah, say if I'm shading this area of clothing on a new layer. La di la di la. Shades, colors, what is art? Anyways, the fringe effect is a really cool way to make the shadows pop. So basically, by checking this box, it adds a really soft outline to your colors. And you can also change the intensity of how like thick the outline is by playing with this bar right here. Then you can soften the edges by using a blur tool on the selected areas, like so. And ta-da! In my personal opinion, this looks a lot better than if you don't have this effect on. But of course, you guys can take this knowledge and use it on whatever else you like. But for me personally, I just like to use them a lot when I do cel shading. But yeah. Okay, now the last two tips are smaller things, but they're still pretty helpful to know. So first off, go to view up here on top and select new. Yeah, like I said, this isn't anything big, but I find it useful to have a smaller version of my art on the side so I can see how the whole picture is coming together, especially because I spend so much time focusing on small details. Note that this is simply a duplicate window of what you're currently working on, so if you hide a layer in the bigger window that you're currently working on, it will hide it in the mini version as well. So my most useful application of this function is, say if I have a reference photo, then I can just minimize it to one small corner of the piece that I know I won't touch, And this way I can now drag it along in the new window until I can find where that reference is. And there. This way you can organize all your refs in the drawing itself in like a folder or something without needing to open it separately. Yeah, it's just a small thing, but I like to keep my workspace organized, so it's really useful for me. Okay, now the last trick that I think y'all should know is this little box here below the button that lets you view slash hide a layer. A lot of you have probably been wondering what this is for, since not very many people cover it. It's a pretty insignificant function in a way, but basically it locks two of your layers together. So say I am currently on this bottom layer here. If I select the pin button of another layer while I'm still on this bottom layer, it locks them together. So now if I were to use the move tool to move the entire layer up here, the bottom layer moves as well, and vice versa. This is pretty cool, but my problem with it is that it can only be used to move the whole layer, but not sections. So if I were to use the lasso tool to only select a bit on the section to move, that same bit on the other section does not move with me. But yeah, therefore in my opinion, this function isn't too useful, but it's still good to know. I mean, if you're someone who actually uses this button, let me know in the comments and educate us all on its other functions. And I think that's it for this tutorial. Thank you guys all so much for watching. There is one thing I didn't get to cover, and that is masks, but since it can get quite confusing, I think I'll probably just save it for my next video to complete my TOOL SAI guide series. So yeah, make sure you guys subscribe for that. But yeah, for now, feel free to check out my other tutorials, like the one on all the functions of the magic wand in SAI, and also my ultimate beginner's guide if you haven't seen that yet. Make sure you leave this video a thumbs up if it helped, and I'll see you all soon with more tutorials and speed paints in the future.